Okay, guys, so this is discrete optimization and a facility location assignment. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go over the assignment, okay, and go over the details of the input-output. Okay, so this is a very intuitive assignment in a sense. So what you have is a bunch of customers. So this is the black dots that you see on the screen. And this is data. This is given to you, right? And so the second thing is that you get a set of location that you see there. These are locations for the facilities, and your goal is to actually find out where you build these facilities. Okay? And there are two costs that will come into play. Every time you open a facility, it will cost you a fixed cost. And then obviously, there will be also the cost of delivering goods from that facilities to the various customers. Okay? And that's a variable cost, which depends on how far the customer is located. Okay? And so in a sense, you have this tension between the fixed cost. If there would be no fixed cost, you would open many of these warehouses. Okay? And the variable cost, the distribution cost of actually shipping the good to the particular customers. Okay? Now, every one of these facilities will also have a particular capacity, and that will tell you how many of these customers it can actually serve. Okay? So basically, tension between the fixed and the variable cost, and also tension because every one of these facilities will have a fixed capacity, okay? A fixed number of customers that it can serve. Okay? So this is a solution. Okay? We open two of these facilities, and you see the customers are allocated to these two facilities. Okay? So that's the goal. Of course, we want to do that for thousands and thousands of customers and hundreds of facilities. Okay? So this is a description of the problem. Okay? I'm going to go over it. It's a terrible model. Okay? There are actually very few solvers who can actually express this model as I'm stating it here. And the reason I'm doing this is because I don't want to influence you on the kind of formulations that you will want to use for solving this problem. Okay? So we'll have N facilities and M customers. Okay? So every customer will have a demand, DC. Okay, for customer C. Okay, that's how much good the customer C wants to get delivered to his facility. Okay, to his its location, and then you will have for every facility where you can actually build a warehouse. Okay, for every site where you can build a facility in a sense. Okay, so you have a cost. That's the cost of building the facility. Okay, and then you have a capacity, which is how many customers that facility can actually serve. Okay, so this is SF and then cap F. Okay, that you see over. Okay, then there will be a cost, for transporting goods from the facility to the customer. Okay, and we're going to use this thing here to actually model that cost. So this is dist FC, which tells you the distance between the distance and also the cost between the facility and the customer C. Okay, and then essentially the only decision variables in the model that I'm showing you here is going to be the set of customer which are allocated to facility F. Okay, so AF is going to be the set of customers that are allocated to facility F. Once you have that, once you have all these decision variables, essentially you have all you need to actually compute the cost and and verify that the constraints are satisfied. Okay, so so I'm going to go over the mathematical formulation. Once again, keep in mind that this is probably not something that you want to use. Okay, so what we are trying to do is minimize for every one of the facilities two things. Okay, the fixed cost and then the variable cost. Okay, the fixed cost is what? Well, you pay the fixed cost. So you build a facility if at least one customer is assigned to the facility. Okay, so if you know that the set of customers assigned to that particular facility is not empty, okay, so that particular expression here is going to be true, okay, you multiply that by the cost of the fixed cost and you get essentially the fixed cost. If no customer is allocated to that facility, this expression is zero, okay? So that's the fixed cost. When you actually assign something to a facility, you have to open it and you pay the fixed cost. And then the second part is essentially looking at all the customers which are allocated to that particular facility and you compute the distance between that customer and the particular facility and you get the variable cost, okay? So that's the objective function. Two part, once again, the fixed cost and the variable cost. And then you have the two constraints. The first one is making sure that no capacity constraints are violated for every one of the facility. You make sure that all the customers which are allocated to that particular facility have a demand which doesn't exceed the capacity. So you take all the customers associated with the facility, you sum the demand of all these customers, and you make sure that this is smaller or equal to the capacity of that facility. Okay? That's the first constraint. The second constraint is obvious. You want to serve every one of your customer. Okay? So you make sure that for a particular customer, if you look at all the facilities, at least one of them has the customer as one of its served customer. Okay? So that's what this constraint is doing. Okay, once again, you know, don't implement that model, it's terrible. Okay? But this is a mathematical expression, precise expression of the problem. Okay? Now let me go over the input-output. Okay? So this is the input that we are giving you. Okay? It's pretty simple in this problem. Okay? So you have the number of facilities, the number of customers. Okay? So that's the first two numbers that you're going to get. Okay? And then essentially afterwards, you get all the information about the facilities and then all the information about the customers. Okay? For the facilities, what do you get? Well, you get a fixed cost, you get a capacity, and then you get the location. Okay? The geographic location, which is, you know, a point in the Euclidean space here. Okay? So that's what you get. And you get that obviously for, you know, all the particular facilities that you have, and they are N of them. And then afterwards you have the same roughly the same information for the customers. What you get for them is essentially the demand that they have in terms of goods, and then the location once again of where they are in the plane. Okay? And so this is essentially the input. So the input is very simple, right? The capacity and the fixed cost for every one of the facilities, including their location. And then for the customers, same thing, you have the demand in terms of the goods, okay? And then you have the locations of the various customers, okay? So that's the input. The output is what you see there. So we want something very, very simple. We want the objective function and whether it's optimal or not, okay? Many of these problems here, you will be able to prove optimality, so this is important. Not all of them, probably, but almost all of them. And then what you see there is basically the list of the customer, the list of the customer, where the customers, which facility are assigned to every one of the customer. So for every one of the customers, we want to know which facility they are assigned to. Okay? So that's the output. Okay? For every one of the customer, which is the facility that the customer is assigned to? And we can deduce, obviously, from that, which facilities are being used. Okay? So this is an example of a particular instance. Okay? So you have three facilities, four customers. Okay? Really baby instance here. You see the various numbers for the fixed cost, for the capacity, and the locations of these two things. And for the customers, that's the same thing. You see the demand, 50, 50, 75, 75, and you see the location in the plane. Okay? In this particular case, this is one of the output. Okay, one possible output. You see the value of the objective function there, 2550.013. Okay, and then it's not optimal. And then you see you see where these particular customers are allocated. You see that customer 0 and customer 1 are allocated to facility 1, customer 2 to facility 0, customer 3 to facility 2. So essentially the assignments that you have here is the one that you see over there, which basically tells you that the facility 0 is serving customer 2, facility 1 is serving customer 0 and 1, and facility 2 is serving customer 3. That's the last thing that you see there. Okay? So this is a description of input-output, okay? Now, we talked a lot about warehouse location in the lecture. Look at this as well, okay? There are different formulations, okay? Whatever you do, there will be different way of modeling this problem, whatever the approach that you take, okay? And different formulation will have different efficiencies. So this is an interesting problem in actually modeling the various points, okay? So you have to think about what is a good formulation in every kind of the models, right? So what is a good formulation for a mathematical programming system, okay? Remember, you know, we talked about that. What is a good formulation for a local search algorithm? Okay, so the two main approaches that I would suggest looking at are local search and mathematical programming. Okay, and if you do local search, one of the critical things in this particular assignment is going to be the speed at which you can actually explore the neighborhood. Okay, so the faster you can explore this neighborhood, the more configuration you can explore. Okay, and in this particular example, there is a beautiful data structure that you can use to speed this up tremendously. Okay. So think about that. Okay, so good luck. Okay, so this is an amazing assignment, very interesting assignment. Okay, it's sufficiently simple such that you can understand it completely, but it's also challenging and various approaches will give you different, you know, trade-offs. So it's a very interesting assignment. Okay, have fun, good luck. And so, you know, we'll see how well you do, and we'll discuss that in some of the mailbags later on. Okay, bye guys, thank you.